Who grew up in Port Harcourt? I was one of the first graduates in the University of Port Harcourt. What has he done for River State? Under Babangida, we got NAFCON, right? We got but actually all the things we got, including federal groups, we have gotten under non-South-South University. When our own son came, when we are going to control our country, and did I think that if we take these resources control, let us see what how you control it. To get this West Road up to Port Harcourt, people who say, oh, it happens or happens or not, or more. Don't you know that? See, you have to work to get the road. But was I a passenger? Was it was I a passenger? It's abandoned. It's abandoned. It's because I said sharpen and fighting man, they said they want to be awarded. And what are they awarded? When I had also decided, I started talking to the men that two of us can fight now to do that. So I wanted to have more by wood instead of dying by water.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, hold on.
I'm aware during your first tenure, he was equally the president of this country. We didn't hear such complaints now.
No, he did listen very well. I was the last government to support President Udo on his first term. The last. You can ask all the governors. And the reason I told it. I said, I'm looking for good governance. I'm looking for the benefits for Nigeria and the benefits for River State. And he assured me.
Okay, you
the
made
the last governor. I repeat, okay. I was the last to support to ask your people.
Okay, sir. You made a statement minutes ago that the supporters can't be, there can't be two people, let me put it in my own words, serving two masters at the same time. Let me put it that way. And you equally said you don't have any personal issues with him. It's just on good governance. Invariably, are you saying that you are for good governance while he's for bad governance?
So if it's that way, you can't do that comparison.
I want to hear from you. I want to hear from you.
You have Chibok here.
Sorry?
You have Chibok here.
Do we have them Chibok here?
I believe you have 200 here.
From? No.
Let me tell you, like, I hear something. I've been with other people. What I say is, when I say that the president is responsible and the federal government for the Chibok here, I meant he may not have got to kidnap people. He may not have the courage to kidnap. But as the president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, he took an oath to protect you and life. The day they kidnap you, he is responsible. That's what I say. I didn't say because I got up one day and kidnap you. I didn't say one day if you have my bed together and finish sugar. But he and I all took an oath. Not like me, who does not have the soldiers to fight back and protect you. The president has soldiers, he has police, he has navy, he has air force to protect their life. So anything that is failure in security, you can only hold one man.
Sure.
Who is that man?
The president.
When you talk about corruption, when I get up here, I tell the person, I tell my local police, I ask them, show me my house, and I'll show you 20 of your own. I've been governor for 7 years, speaker for 8 years. Show me my private house and I'll show you bridge of your own. Yesterday when I spoke, I said, we have had minister before. One minister, one small minister, just bought all the houses to Port Harcourt, bought 1.1 behind me here, and it's living large. It's not afraid. You know it's not afraid? Because corruption is now the norm at the final level. If not, who are you under the candidate to be a minister and build a mighty house? Where you invite the wife of the president and she comes in, she doesn't ask you, where do they get the money? But still, I didn't tell you who is bad governance and good governance. I'm just comparing so that you can make your judgment. So you can't be for good governance and be for bad governance.
At last, you haven't answered me, sir. You haven't answered the last question. I asked if it's possible, if you think it's still possible to synergize and work towards
today,
yes,
to good governance. Why would I abandon?
No.
But you can't learn left hand.
This is an online. There's some questions coming in on social media. The questions have been, one, why have the British company neglected road construction in Bolokiri area of Port Harcourt? Two, why is the share of funds not going to specific areas, especially on Africa? Three, as a member of the AOC, would you in total total sincerity ascribe that the APC manifesto can bring any change or need to improve it? And finally, why is there no change on the university? Why is it so difficult to resolve for the school issue?
Quick answer. Every rural government has shopping. Because that was the last, because they are fighting among themselves. Now, I get that.
Give me a second.